So this week I wanted to end off of talking about inclusivity in the workplace and diversity. And I recently talked to someone that shared a situation that they had in the workplace that really shows us how we might set up people that have issues with mental health in a way that makes it difficult to get the respect that they need at work. So there was two employees, and it was a corporate situation where there was a bullpen situation where everybody had open offices, and one employee had an office with walls and the other didn't. And what happened was the person with in the bullpen apparently was struggling with some issues related to anxiety and could not focus, and went to, I believe, a manager to discuss his concerns. The person with the office, apparently did not have those concerns. What management did, which, you know, unfortunately was such a difficult move, or wrong move, I should say, is that they moved the person having the issue with anxiety into the other person's office without telling them. So the employee walked in to work after being on the road for a bit and was told that their office was moved without any discussion with either the manager or HR. So this is a situation that shows that what ended up happening is then the person that was moved thought, why was I treated differently, and not told that the change was going to occur, not help having the person understand what was going on. And that created, obviously, speculation about why the other person got that office. From an HR perspective, it really is important to deal with these things in a diplomatic way. Communication is key. If there are concerns where there's accommodations needed because of mental health in the workplace, it's so very important that we do it in a uniformed way. My example is one where it's done poorly, and for employers to recognize that we need to respect people that need inclusivity in the workplace, but we also have to be respectful of team dynamics when we do make a move, and there are ways to do it and ways not to. Hope this was helpful, and I would love your feedback on the video. This is Roxanne Durhodge of the Authentic Connection Movement. Take care.